Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be talking about database transactions. Suppose let's say you are registering a user over here and you are also assigning them role. You are doing two database operations over here. But let's say you saved the user and when you are assigning role to the user, something went wrong. It means that the user will present in the database, but these roles will not be present in the database. But what we want is, we want everything to be rolled back whenever something went wrong. We don't want user to be created. So in that case, database transaction will help us. So let me show you what I mean. So here I have this user registration forms. We have only name, email, password, and role. Let me show you that. Here in the home controller, it is taking me to this welcome view with the roles. And here is a form. So we have this name, email, password, and role, and we are submitting this to this save user. It is here, the save user controller, and here I am creating a user and attaching role to the user. And I'm just sending a message here, and this roles is a relationship in the user model. So here, if I show you in the bottom, this belongs to many relationship. Okay, so let me just fill the form over here using this form filler and just click on save. Then it is saying me user created successfully. And if I come here in the database, so there were 10 users before, and now there is this one user added. And here in the role user also, we have this user ID 11 has the role of 3, and this role is this editor role. So this is what happens when everything is working perfectly fine. But let's say something gone wrong whenever we are attaching a role, or you may have other things that are being performed in this controller, and in any one of those operations something might go wrong. But let me say here, something went wrong by throwing an exception manually. I'm just simulating that something has gone wrong. Now again, if I come here in the browser and fill the form and save it, then we can see here something went wrong. But if you see here in the code, the user is already created, but the roles are not created. But in our system, the roles must be attached to the user, but here it is not happening. So let me show you that. Here in the users table, the user is this. And here in the role user table, there is nothing. The user is not attached to the role. In such kind of scenario, we want to roll back the changes. We want to revert back the creation of the user. So in that case, database transactions will be very, very handy. So let me show you how to do it. DB transaction list, and this DB is facade over here. It is over here. And here the first parameter is function like this, or closer. And we have to pass whatever we want to perform inside this DB transaction. And here we need to pass the request. Now we did this, but let's say there was no error at first, then everything will work as it is. But now let's say something went wrong whenever we are attaching role to the user. Then I'll come back and fill in the form, and you can see here the username is this. And let me just click on save like this. And we can again see the same exception. But if I come here in the database users, and if I just refresh here, there is no user, which means that it created that user and again it rolled back. And here in the roles user also, we don't have the roles. And this is the power of database transactions. You can easily roll back whatever you have performed if something gone wrong in your application. But there are some things that you need to care before using this database transaction. And let me show you. Now let me send an email over here. Mail to user send. And we want to send the welcome email to the user whenever the user is created. Send welcome email, and we'll pass the user like this. Okay, we created a user. We sent mail to that user, and then we tried to attach role. But let's say something went wrong as we have seen before, and we are adding everything inside the database transaction. And also let me show you here mail trap. There are no mails over here. Okay. And let me come here again and fill the form. So here is this user, Martin Logan. And if I try to save, then we can see the same exception error message. And if I come here in the database, everything is as before. The user is not saved in the database. And here in the role user also, we don't have anything. But if we come here in the mail trap, we can see the mail over here. So hi, Martin, welcome to the Laratips. And I can show you that mail. This, sorry, not here. So this welcome message, so this is coming from this welcome mail. And let me also show you that mail.php file. So here this is just the user and just returning this markdown, and this is the markdown content, and we can see that here. Now the user is not even present in the database and we have already sent them the mail. So this is the problem with the database transaction. And let us also see what happens when we are queuing the mail, okay? And also I'll show you how to solve this issue as well. So let me again go back, and here in my code, let me go to the save user controller, and inside the send welcome mail, okay, here I'll do implements should queue, and it is so easy to queue the mail in the Laravel. Just add this implements should queue. Okay, we have added this mail to the queue. Now in order to send the mail, we need to run this php artisan queue listen like this. So whenever we are using in development, just use queue listen, because it will listen to every changes that we have made. So it is listening to the queue, and let me just make it a little bit lower. So here again we are creating the user, sending the mail, and something went wrong over here. And this thing is added to the queue now. And in the laravel.log file, let me remove everything from here. Okay, now let me come here in the browser and again fill the form and save it. And it is very fast now, and it is showing us the same error. But if I come here, it is showing me this failed, okay? The mail is not sent, but this is added to the queue. But what we want is, we don't even want this mail to be added to the queue if something went wrong. So one thing is that it is added to the queue, we don't want that. And it is failing over here, it is not sending any mail. So if you look here in the mail tab, we cannot see any new email. It is failing. It is failing because the user is created, but something went wrong, and this mail is added to the queue, so it will not be immediately sent. It will take some time to be sent. And whenever something is added to this queue, and we have passed this user over here, and here we can see here this user model, it is type hinted over here, so Laravel will try to find that user by performing your database operations. But something has gone wrong over here. Because of this, everything is already rolled back, which means that the created user is already gone. Before, when we were not adding this mail to the queue, then the user was present over there because everything was synchronous, so it was able to send the mail to that user. And whenever we write only user model here, it will take the email from that user, okay? But here it is added to the queue, so it will try to find the user by performing a database operation. So it will not be able to find that user, and it will not be able to send the mail to the user. So that's why it failed over here. So now let me show you how to fix it, and let me show you that in the documentation as well. So here in the documentation, we can see here queued mailables and database transaction. We can write this after commit over here. Let me go to the VS code over here, and here in the controller, so I'll just wrap this thing inside the brackets, and here I'll say after commit like this. And let me again show you this queue listen code over here, and let me just clear this queue listen and restart it so that we'll only see one mail that is queued or not. Okay, it is like this, everything is cleared. Okay, here let me go back and fill the form one more time and save it. We can again see this exception, something went wrong. But if I show you here, nothing is added to the queue now, which means that this database transaction rolled back everything because of some error, and this was not able to execute because here we have written after commit. And also let me show you here inside the database transaction also this transaction code, and let me go here inside this connection, and here in the manages transaction, and we have this transaction method over here, and here we have this commit. Okay, so this will be performed after this callback. So this callback is whatever that is written over here, and whatever we have passed from this closure, so in the first parameter, this is this callback. Okay, after this callback is called or executed, then only this commit is performed. So now we have added here this after commit, which means that only after this commit this mail will be sent. But here whenever we execute this callback, so when we execute this callback, then it is throwing an error over here, okay, like this, like this. So because of that, it is not even able to reach this commit. So this mail is not sent. And also we can perform this after commit in several different ways. Let me show you here. We can just write this after commit in the constructor. So let me show you here in the send mail, welcome mail. We can just write it over here like this. And we don't need to write it over here. Let me just undo the changes like this. So we can also write it over here. And this is same case for jobs, events and listeners, broadcasting. And I'll be leaving the link of every one of those from the documentation just below that like button. You can see in some cases we need to write here public property, and in some cases we have to write it here inside the construct. So for that you need to look into the documentation. Okay, now at last, so let me just remove this or just comment it out, and every other thing is same, which means that nothing is wrong over here. Okay, and let me open this queue listen as well, and let me just go back, fill the form and save. Now user is created successfully. So we can see here this queue is processed, and here in the mail tab we can see this new mail, and here in the users table also we have this new user. And you can see here from 12 it has directly reached to 17, which means that whenever database transaction is performed, the data is inserted in the database and again removed. So this user was created and it was again removed. And here in the role user also we can see this role ID that has attached to the user 17, and you can see this ID also 17. So in this way database transactions are very helpful to us, and also whenever we are using it with the asynchronous actions or like queues, jobs, notification, broadcasting, then we need to think twice, because the mail could be sent to the user even if user is not present in the database, like we have seen in the example.